Quickly, this is a paid segment from skinswap.com. Log into skinswap today to be able to easily trade, buy, and most importantly for us, sell skins. Skinswap even supports PayPal, so it's quite accessible for everyone. Don't forget to use my affiliate code OMIGHTY to help me out. And also claim your free item at the top right of the website screen too.
What's going on, guys? OMIGHTY back at the end with all weekly Rust Skins videos. And today we have a pretty interesting looking week with the Brutalist themed stuff. So is this Force? I honestly have already forgotten. Yeah, this is Force. So this is the first day or the first week that the Brutalist new stone skin, just to be clear, it's for stone now, not metal. Face Punch did change that. That's out now in the Rustum store going for $19.95. Just a little bit of feedback to Face Punch. I mean, I get all these for free, but I reckon the Adobe Brick and Brutalist should all be put together and be sold for like $20 Australian instead of them being sold individually for $20 Australian. I think that's a little bit expensive, honestly. And we'll just quickly have a look, clicking on all the things here apparently. We'll quickly have a look at the top sellers. So Brutalist is selling for number one. And of course, that isn't marketable on the community market once it leaves the Rustum store, which it actually won't, because it's going to go into the general. But then after that, we have the Brutalist Garage Door, which is indeed a limited item. So, all right, let's get started with the limited stuff. And we'll get started with the clothing and armor. And we have the Thunder Gold Metal Face Mask and Chest Plate, both going for $3.95 each, which is above center store price for clothing and armor. And look, honestly, I am not a big fan of like the lightning bolts on skins. It's just not my style personally. And I know that that is, sorry about my dog in the background. And I know that that is obviously the theme of this skin. But I mean, like, this set would look awesome if it didn't have the lightning bolts. Like, I like the pattern, the textured pattern on the actual metal. And I do like the white and gold theme. So, I mean, you know, whatever. Of course, it's just based around like thunder and lightning, Kachiga and Kachiao. Both going for $3.85 each, though. It is above center store price. This set is probably going to continue because Helk has been on a roll when it comes to continuing skins these days, and I think it's like the new model for the Rustum store for skins to continue once they come out and sets to be complete. So overall, with the Thunder Gold face mask and chest plate, honestly, I just think they're too expensive to buy off the Rustum store, especially for $3.85 each. So overall, for both of these items, I'm going to recommend picking them up off of the community market, the buy order, if you do plan on investing with them, because I do think you can get them for cheaper than the $3.95 each that they're going for on the Rustum store. All right, moving over to the Ronin Road Sign Glove. So what have we had so far? We've had the Metal Gear, we've had the Road Sign, we've had the Kilt. Now we've got the Road Sign gloves. I'm honestly a little bit surprised that we haven't got Ronin boots as well. Perhaps they haven't been made, but I do think that it is interesting. I don't think they actually really need them. Sorry that you can hear my dog in the background. But like, yeah, they're going to be pretty easy to pair. The set's going to be pretty easy to pair with like just a black pair of boots or something like that, which are pretty cheap for the like the standard Face Punch black pair. But of course, the blackout boots are a bit more expensive. So the Ronin Road Sign gloves, they're only $1.55 each. So overall, I will recommend investing in them. I think Road Sign gloves are pretty safe investments. And I think this is also the only red pair of Road Sign gloves we have. Just have to keep in mind that tactical gloves are a thing and they are better than Road Sign gloves. So once you do get tactical gloves, typically the Road Sign gloves will get replaced unless you do just want to look dripped out with the certain skin that you have. And now we move over to the UAP pilot satchel, because of course that used to be a an item in the clothing and armor for some reason. So this is going for $3.05, is above standard store price for satchels and other weapons and tools. Overall, I'm pretty sure this does glow in the dark, but I'm not 100%. You guys will be checking that out now. If it does glow in the dark, I do think that I would definitely avoid this. Because, I mean, like, if you're going to be prim gear and you're finally doing your first raid with your garbage satchels, then you probably don't want to be running over to a base in the dark with a little glowing part on your leg. Overall, though, I think it's a cool skin. Of course, it's a standout-looking satchel skin, but at the same time, we already have a decent amount of satchels at the moment, satchel skins, and satchel skins just don't really perform that well, in my opinion. It's a cool satchel skin, but the satchel charges themselves are absolutely garbage. I hate using them in game personally. And also, like, you're just going to throw it and the skin's going to be gone. So it doesn't really matter. $3.05 is quite expensive as well. So overall, I'm not going to recommend investing in the UAP pilot satchels off of the Rustlandem store. And if you do want to try and invest in them, I'd recommend getting them off the Rust, the community market with the buy order. But overall, I wouldn't recommend investing in them at all. All right, so that is the clothing and armor done. That's the first weapon. And we'll look at the Arctic Skull SMG. I actually really like the Arctic Skull set, but it just hasn't performed well. This SMG is going for $3.05, which is about standard store price for weapons and tools at the moment. I really love how the magazine is the bottom jaw of the skull every time, so you unload the bottom jaw and then reload it. I think that just looks, it's a nice touch. It really looks really nice. I actually think the custom is the best Arctic Skull we've had so far. Also, a little shout out to the skin creator, because in the Rustlandem store screenshots, they have a screenshot of the Arctic Skull metal gear, and it does say pick armor please on the picture. So I think adds a little bit of personality to the skin creator as well. And of course, that also does mean that the metal gear has been made for it. Overall, the custom does look very nice, but the custom is kind of like the lowest tier of the SMGs, and I don't think it's a bad SMG, but for $3.05, I do think that you could get it for cheaper off of the community market with a buy order. And so overall, I'm not going to recommend investing in the Arctic Skull SMG off of the Rustlandem store, and that is also because the other Arctic Skull weapon skins haven't performed well after leaving the Rustlandem store and going to the community market. Nice skin though, don't get me wrong. All right, moving over to the Chameleon SAR. I don't know how these have been performing on the market because I haven't really been checking lately, but if they're performing well on the community market, then I'd recommend copying it. You guys can do some research for yourself. Go to Steam, go to the community market, and check out how the Chameleon set is performing. But if it's like above $4, then I'd recommend getting it. Either way, I'm still going to recommend getting it. Spoiler. And that is mainly because as a medium to long-term investment, I think this can make you money. I think in like 2 months, this will be making you money, actually slightly over 2 months. Just after Christmas, this should be making you money. I also don't really think we're going to be getting other like chameleon style skins anytime soon. So overall, I do think that these are going to be quite a unique standout skin for each gun. And also they are just continuing to come out. So I mean, they're pretty awesome. Also, I was using the AK all day today, all afternoon on Rust. And it's just a really nice looking skin. So overall, I will recommend investing the Chameleon SAR off of the Rustlandem store, or you could potentially try and increase your profits by trying to get it for a little bit cheaper off of the community market. But honestly, I don't think you're going to get it for too much cheaper. Just remember to check out the community market before you do buy it off the Rustlandem store though. But overall, I think it'll be a good long-term investment nonetheless. Alrighty, moving over to the final weapon of the week, we have the Concentric MP5, and I know that this probably doesn't actually have anything to do with lightning, but I do think that this would actually pair quite well with the Thunder Gold chestplate and face mask, which is quite a coincidence. It is a gold-themed MP5 with a wooden charging handle and backstock and pistol grip. Overall, yeah, I don't know, not so keen. $3.05 as well. Skin looks a little bit amateur in my opinion, like, to be honest. I think that it's probably like a first kind of skin. But I mean, don't get me wrong, it doesn't look bad. $3.05 is what it's going for as well. We already have so many nice looking MP5 skins, plus we also get free MP5 skins from the Twitch drops, so it does make it a little bit harder to invest in MP5 skins these days. Overall, the MP5 just got a buff as well, this wipe. So that definitely is a plus, but I'm not going to recommend investing in the Concentric MP5 off of the Rustlandem store still. I don't know how substantial the MP5 buff was because I haven't been using the MP5. Overall, I'm not going to recommend investing in the Concentric MP5 off of the Rustlandem store. And if skins for the MP5 were to increase, I honestly don't think this would be one of them. So not going to recommend investing in that, but nice skin. Alright, that's all the weapons done, and now we've just got the deployables left, so we'll look at the Brutalist Garage door, and this is a very interesting door skin. Whoever made this is a clever little duck. This is a glowing deployable, but that's not the only pay-to-win aspect of this door skin. It also has a window in the middle, which you can't shoot in and out of if you are new to Rust. You can't shoot through those little pixels. So technically there is actually garage door still there, but they are pay to win because you can use them as like a front garage door and you can like look through them and stuff like that. The only problem with this garage door now is the fact that it's $6.15. So it's much more above standard store price than your regular deployable or your regular garage door, which is a shame because it does make it a lot harder to invest in, but it also does make it, have a lower quantity on the community market. So overall, the Brutalist garage door is definitely a little bit of a 50-50 here. The fact that it's $6.15, I honestly do think you can get the Brutalist garage door off of the community market for a bit cheaper, but as a long-term investment, unless more garage doors with windows come out, or if the Twitch drops has like a windowed garage door, then that's definitely going to be a problem. But overall, I think the Brutalist garage door could make you money as a long-term investment, but I'd recommend trying to get it off the community market with a buy order to maximize your potential profits, because $6.15 is a little bit expensive to be buying off the Rust Atom store. And you have to keep in mind the Steam tax once you sell it on Steam, or if you sell it on a third-party website. You just have to keep that in mind because it's costing you $6.15 initially. So you could be selling it for like $8 and still not really making money. So keep that in mind. And moving over to the Neanderthal furnace, I'm pretty sure this is the third Neanderthal skin we've had. We had the sleeping bag and we had something else. I honestly don't even remember. I think this is the third one. I actually really like the set, but I don't think it's going to really go anywhere. I don't think you're going to make money off of it. It's $2.30. So quick answer for that one. Don't really think you're going to make money off of it. I'm not going to recommend investing in it. Awesome looking skin, but just everyone uses glowing deployables these days, and glowing deployables are king. Like, they are the meta. Even though it's not like a crazy like pay to win thing, like you can just turn on your torch, or you can turn on your weapon flashlight, or you can turn on a campfire, or you can turn on electricity, like lights and stuff like that. Like, there's a lot of ways around glowing deployables, so you don't have to use them, but they're just beneficial to use. And I think pretty much everyone is going to use glowing deployables. And of course, like, furnace skins only glow when they're actually lit anyway, but I still just think that like glowing furnaces are more stand out for the community and just perform better overall. I do think the Neanderthal furnace is pretty awesome, but I'm not going to recommend investing in it off of the Rust Atom store. And yeah, that's the end of all of the skins. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and remember, have a skits one.